Yay, we have an audience. Good morning, everybody. Happy Sunday to all of you. This is Brittany at Big Cat Rescue in Tampa, Florida. We don't have a guide for a virtual tour today, but I figured I would at least take a little bit of time to just kind of wander around and show you a couple of the cats. The first cat I actually want to head over to, I know all of you guys have been asking about like crazy, and that is Pharaoh. Pharaoh actually came back outside, I believe it was on Friday. And so I'll show you the new thing that Victor and Jamie built for him, and it looks like he's really been enjoying it. So figured we'd start here with our beautiful Tiger Lake. It's just now, these clouds are finally starting to part a little bit and we're seeing some blue sky. It was very dreary this morning. So good morning. Make sure that you guys share this feed and let people know that Big Cat Rescue is live. And I'm just gonna show you a couple of cats this morning to make up for the fact that we don't have a guide for a virtual tour today. Hopefully, I have one on the sign-up sheet for next week. But we shall see. We can't do the tours if we don't have enough people to make sure that the cat care is 100%. So if that's the case, I'll just keep trying to do these walkabouts for you like I usually do during the week. Miss Jasmine's finishing up breakfast. She's got her new den and all of her new sand. I think they have to do one more coat on that den and then it'll be totally done. So right now, all of our feeders are still out feeding. So they're probably in the stage of kind of observing and then picking up for anyone who might have left something. So it looks like they are feeding Mr. Dez over there. So my goal is to make it over to Pharaoh. Thank you so much, Amanda, for the donation. Really appreciate you guys, everyone who donates and everyone who shares and everyone who helps newcomers in the comments. When I'm driving, I can't always shout out to you guys, so thank you for all of that support. So we'll get parked over here and we'll go pop in and see if we can see Pharaoh. Nancy for the donation. So hopefully he's still out and about. If not, oh yep, I see him. Oh, and he's eating, so I don't want to distract him. Maybe I can zoom in from here. Mr. Pharaoh! He's staring at me. We might have to backtrack, but he's outside. We'll let him finish his food and then we'll come back to him. Let's go see if the boys are done eating breakfast. There's a little sneak preview of what they built for Pharaoh for him to come back outside. I'll explain all of that, but for now, let's pop over, kind of keep an eye on him from a distance. See what Flintster's up to. Want to distract him from eating. Oh, thank you, Willie, for the donation. Where are you running off to? He's like, oh, someone's here to put us back together, but that's not true. So I promise we'll go back to Pharaoh. I'm watching him out of the corner of my eye. I just want him to eat breakfast, so.
Mister, are you still waiting on breakfast? Is that what the deal is?
Maybe that's what's happening here. This is his feeding lockout. So he's all kinds of excited to keep running in and out of there. So Flint is on this side. Nabisco is on the other side.
Hi, bud.
They must still be waiting on breakfast.
You guys must be waiting on breakfasters. This is Biscuit. Hi, Nabisco. Cute boy. Cute boy. Yeah. Yeah. Are you guys waiting on breakfast? Or I can't tell because you're usually a clean plate, so it looks like breakfast is gone. Thank you, Robin, very much for the donation. Nope, I think they're waiting on breakfast. Interesting. Maybe they fed Pharaoh and kind of cleared out and they'll come back for everybody else. Smalls is perfect as always, but she is currently hiding in her den right in the background there. She gets a little untrusting during breakfast sometimes. It also appears that they completely might have raked around her enclosure over there, so she will also lose trust with people for several days because of that as well. I do see Gilligan out, so if Pharaoh's not done, maybe we'll pop over and see Gilligan. And we'll bring Smalls out of her shell, and then we'll pop back over for Pharaoh, because I do not want to distract him. It's very important that he eats his food. So let's pop over and see Gilligan. He's out on the move. And then I promise we will come right back. But it's very exciting that he's back outside. Hi, Gil. Were they raking over here? Looks like they raked around Smalls, but not Gilligan yet. Small girl. Hi, honey. Woo! Oh, there he goes. Woo. And there he stops. Short-lived. My goodness. Gilligan. Oh, where are you going? Whoa, lady. Smalls. Small girl. I was coming to say hi to you, silly. Oh my goodness. Oh my very goodness. That was very fast. That was very, very fast. You just tore on out of here. Yes, you did. Yes, you did, lady. What you been doing? I missed you this weekend. He did. I guess that was good enough. Maybe she did get jealous. She was like, fine, you wanted to look at him? Because he makes cool noises? Well, I can run really fast. Exactly. Oh, all the way up onto her platform. She is a nut.
Am I supposed to follow?
Thank you, Janet, for the donation. Let's pop back over here and see Gilligan. I'm just trying to keep an eye on Pharaoh because I want to go over and see him, but I don't want to disrupt his breakfast. That is very important. Hi, Bob. You started wooing and then you were like, eh, it's just not really that worth it. Not that worth it. Up until now, we've only seen some bobcats. So this is a Canada lynx. He's much larger, much fluffier. Huge feet. That's wonderful, Amanda. I'm glad Smalls is one of your sponsor cats. If any of you guys want to sponsor any of the cats that you see here at Big Cat Rescue, you can do that on our website. It's our online store, which is at bigcatrescue.biz.
With a new month coming, we should have a new sponsorship list coming out. And hopefully I can update you guys on who might be at the bottom of that list now, because you surely made sure that the one that was in the bottom in December is not there anymore. I'm really excited to see the numbers. Where are you running to? We are very zoomy today. Well, probably once we go see Pharaoh, I'll take you guys out to see Jinx on Funcation. We didn't get to follow Breezy and Jinx coming and going from Funcation on Thursday, so we'll check in with them today. Where are we going, Sass Pants? We're going really far away from where I wanted to be. I love that she has decided to love every single bubble of her new enclosure. When we moved her over here, I was really afraid that she'd be like just too exposed, because her entire enclosure is along the tour path. And so when golf carts go by and things like that. But you've really made it your own, didn't you? Yeah. Such a brave girl. Not the cat that came here over 5 years ago. Or not, I guess it wasn't over 5 years ago. We're probably getting close to 5 years. I just wish I knew what kind of imaginary game she was playing. It's gotta be super fun. Super fun games. Super fun games, lady. Back and forth, back and forth. She'll do this until she decides it's time to nap. For some reason, I have all of a sudden not seeing new comments. Apologize if you guys are asking something that I don't see. Hopefully everybody else can see them. It's just stayed stuck on saying that like so many people just started watching. You really caught up to me, didn't you? Well, thank you, Kelly, for the donation. We really just kind of got started. We've seen Flint and Nabisco for a short minute. We got a Gilligan woo. We've seen Smalls go crazy a couple of times. She's purring like crazy too. I'm gonna head over and see if Pharaoh's done eating. Gilligan's back up on the move. She just ran up to the top of her platform. What'd they give you for breakfast? Crazy juice? Crazy juice? Huh? What'd you get? I put some caffeine in your breakfast. So darn cute. Okay, Gilligan went to the other side there. All right, let's go see the most requested guy. I know we've all been really worried about him. This is really weird. I am no longer seeing any of your comments, so I apologize if I'm not responding to you. It's just showing me that, like, David Smith and seven other people are watching, so I'm only seeing one name at a time, and I'm not seeing anything else you guys are saying, so sorry about that. There's that boy. Hi, Pharaoh. So for any of you that are new to us or hadn't had any kind of update on him.
Hi, bud. Mr. Pharaoh, he's our 22-year-old white African serval. They are not normally white. They are usually black and tan, spots and stripes. He has a trait called leucism that creates that white coat. Sadly means his parents were a little too closely related. But Mr. Pharaoh, if you times his age by 6, that's what he'd be in human years. So 22 times 6, it's our sweet old man. You can see he's still missing a patch of fur on his neck from when we drew some blood. Unfortunately, his blood work got a little bit worse than we had hoped. But we think he'd be much happier if he was outside. So he's outside, he's eating, he's taking his meds. We're using those two factors to kind of monitor his health at this point. He's getting super spoiled by Jamie and everyone else, of course. So if you guys recall, you know that Jamie and Victor built Pharaoh his own little tiki hut. So it used to be all open on the sides and it had a thatched roof on it. And it was really, really cute. And because he's a cat, he used to lay under it more than he would lay in it. But what they did is they basically created this, where they put a whole new roof on it that slants to keep him nice and dry. He's got a step up to it. And now it has full sides to keep him sheltered. They put fresh straw in there and he just finished eating breakfast, which is why I was avoiding him at first. But now he's all cozy. He actually was out and down on the step there. You can see he's also got a spice bag. So it looks like he ate a good portion of his breakfast. Now he's settled back into nap. A very good spot to nap. So what we've done is he has access to this box here that he really likes. He's also got access to that really pretty area over there with those trees. He's always liked kind of patting and clawing at trees around him. He's got a couple trees here. He's got a kooloroo bed. And then he actually has this really big den over here as well that he has access to. But as of now, this is all we've opened him back up to because we want to keep him in a smaller area so that we can really monitor him. Thank you very much to everybody who has donated this morning. Really means a lot. We've been closed since last March 16th of 2020. So every day that goes by, we're getting closer and closer to having been a full year without our guided educational tour revenue. So you guys have been absolutely priceless in your support with us, so thank you. He's like, okay, it's full belly, time to nap. Bye, sweet boy. What a sweet boy. All right, well, I know everybody had really, really wanted an update on Pharaoh, so now you know he is back outside. And as far as I know, he's been doing okay since he came out on Friday. He's eating. Here's Gilligan back up and about again. So I was gonna walk down and just show you guys Jinx. Jinx is in Funcation now. Hi, silly. Hi.
Gilligan again. What you doing, sir?
Woo!
Out on his morning walk. What he really is telling me to do is to toss some kind of treat into his feeding lock out there. You know those games. All right, we're just gonna walk down there and see if we spot anybody else along the way. Biscuit's now eating breakfast. He's very easily distracted though, so we will keep walking. Again, I'm so sorry. I can't see that any of you are saying anything. I just see who's watching. And it only gives me one name and tells me like six other people are watching, so welcome. If you came in late and you want to see Pharaoh or hear any of the updates or see any of the cats that we've already seen so far, you can rewatch at dailybigcat.com. There's a Sheena. Hi, Sheena. Sheena's going to be our birthday girl tomorrow. So what we're going to keep doing for the rest of the year is featuring all day on Facebook and Instagram. We will be featuring our birthday cats, which you can see with Sheena can be pretty difficult because she's not very sociable. But we'll try to spend maybe a little more actual time with her tomorrow. Hi, Hutchkins. Hi, Ginger. So all of these servals. So as I mentioned earlier, that Pharaoh's a serval, but he has leucism with that white coat. This is what an African serval would look like. Hi, Bob. Of course, he is a bad example because he's way less hissy and aggressive. Of course, he still pees on everything, scratches everything, and is very food aggressive. But he comes across a lot more friendly than, say, Ginger, who just disappeared back there. Oh, it looks like Jinx is about to have breakfast with Jen, so that's probably what we're gonna watch. We're gonna watch you have breakfast with Jinx. I know. I didn't get to show them him coming over on Thursday, so I was like, let's go check in with him. And then I'm like, oh, now he's getting breakfast. Nice. Sure. Yeah, I'll come in. Stay back, though. Yeah, he's even on vacation. He knows how to be the sneakiest boy. I saw an ear.
I don't know where he is.
I only see one eyeball and an ear.
I wish the leopard would come eat his food. Oh, there he is.
Good job, bud. So I know a lot of you guys have been a little worried about him too. Last Sunday he was on our feeding tour and he ate really fast and regurgitated it and then ate it again. And then unfortunately he did that two other times this week. So I think you just gotta slow down, sir. It's pretty common. A lot of cats do that, but he wasn't really known for doing that. But here recently it's been a thing.
Mm-hmm. So it's not like he's slurping it.
Yep, so he got, it looks like a
thigh.
A thigh, a drum, and some mush, which is basically like a ground up beef diet. Oh! Deb, are you still on here? Try to write a comment. I'm not seeing anyone say anything. It's only showing me that people are watching, but it's not showing me anything you guys are saying. I don't know if we changed something on the comments, but hello, is anyone out there? I know 321 people are out there, but I can't see anything anyone's saying.
They're just in awe and enamored.
Maybe, yeah.
So they can't even
type. Maybe so. I can agree with that. Good job, buddy.
You got two more spots. Come on, I see them right there.
Gotta use your nose. Did you do meds this morning?
Mm-hmm.
How was Pharaoh?
So he looked at it. And I was like, oh, but he's like not wanting to go down on his steps. So
oh,
I left
okay.
It for him so
gotcha.
He could figure that out without being watched.
Gotcha. Okay.
So I'm going to go back. There's one over here, Jinx. Don't make me weigh it. Like, to your right. Now back.
Follow
back,
that nose.
Back.
Oh, water time. So close. So close. Good job, bud.
So we'll see. I gotta go back and I gotta check him. And then Tut ate some. And then it's like, and then I gave him some kibble with the stuff on top. And he's like, oh, that's better.
Typical so, Tut.
I gotta go check on the two of them. And Servi, I think she ate also.
Mm-hmm. She's been doing amazing. She's like really loving that enclosure. Oh, somebody else's stock that might have food.
Well, seems like he's gonna keep everything going.
I think so. That's good. He's covered in those green things, green stickies. Aw, bud. Stands out so well on your black fur. So Jinx is stalking Keeper Barbara Ann over there, just in case she has something extra. He's like, well, technically my other lockout's over there, so let me back over there. I'll eat there too.
They'll pick up another cat.
Right. All right, so we're gonna walk down and just hang with Jinx for just a couple of minutes, and then I think we're gonna call it a day because I feel really awkward. I can't communicate with any of you guys. So I'm so sorry if I haven't been able to answer any of your questions because I haven't seen them. But if you want to rewatch and see any of the cats we saw today, you can do that at dailybigcat.com. Really, really appreciate everybody who helped us get to $98 of donations today.
I love you too, but I don't have
He was like, I see Jen with my bucket and it has my name on it. Yeah, your donations are absolutely priceless. That's what makes it so worth us, you know, coming out and trying to film absolutely everything we can live to keep you guys in the loop so you know what's going on here. You can follow all your favorite cats. We know Jinx is a favorite, and if you do want to watch Jinx live while he's on Funcation, that's a 2-week vacation time where he's in this 22,000 square foot enclosure, and it has an Explore camera in it, and you can find all of our Explore cameras if you go to bigcatcams.com. Awkward spot and I can't see you. I can see the wire. All right, well, this live's going downhill fast, guys, so I thank all of you guys for joining me for just a short little walkabout this morning, and I will hopefully see you guys again each day this week. So take care, everybody. Thank you.